Now, there's something really awesome that you can do called a Roth conversion. It's something that I love to teach about. You can actually take money that's growing tax deferred in a traditional IRA and convert that to a Roth IRA. Now, when you do that, you are going to pay taxes on whatever amount you move into the Roth. It's basically taxable as ordinary income in whatever year you do that conversion. But once you pay the taxes on that acorn, as we call it, the money tree, everything else that grows from there for the rest of your life grows completely tax-free. So I always tell people, you know, if you see yourself substantially growing this retirement account or this IRA by the time you hit retirement, I would highly recommend at least do some of your investments in a Roth IRA. You know, I'm not telling you you should convert your entire account. That might be a little bit of a big tax bill if you've, you know, got decent money in your IRA, but maybe just convert pieces at a time each year. Maybe base that off of what upcoming investment that you have. You know, don't convert the entire account, but if you have a really good investment coming up that you think is going to pay off really nicely, consider doing that Roth conversion before you do that investment. Now, all of that profit from that deal is going back into the Roth IRA, completely tax-free. You can immediately turn back around and reinvest it. And again, it's about that compounding growth. It's not about what you make this year. It's about how can I grow it now and continue to grow it over the next 5, 10, 20 years. Because again, this is your retirement account. You know, this isn't your money to live off of today, but this is your money for retirement. And you know, as Americans and as we earn money and as tax brackets go up, you know, just depending on things in the world, you know, you are going to want to find ways to shelter your investments from taxes. And a Roth IRA or just an IRA or maybe a health savings account is a really great way to do that. You know, it just, again, kind of comes down to you being creative and finding those investments for your IRA. But once you do, there's so many advantages there.